sold.
In this paper, I will attempt to collect contemporary artistic practices of site-specific sound compositions and to allocate sound interventions in urban public space, such as sound walks, audio walks, and listening walks, with the concept of nomadism, as introduced and explained by Deleuze and Guattari in both books of Capitalism and Schizophrenia and the Diplomatato. My goal is firstly to demonstrate how creating site-specific and interactive artistic works with the use of locative media technology results to an environment of augmented orality within public space, and secondly to describe how a minimal nomad art can branch around walking randomly and listening to in the city as a small space, thus creating experimentation with the new media of inscription, which is being established between new media applications and urban public space. So sound walks, listening walks, and audio walks as artistic practices encourage conscious listening and interaction with the sound environment. There is a distinction between these three. A listening walk is walking while concentrating in hearing the existing sounds of an area. A sound walk is the exploration of a specific area soundscape with the use of a score as a guide. Usually the score being a map that draws the attention of the listener to unusual sounds or places to stand or listen throughout the walk. And an audio walk is a walk in which the soundscape of an area is augmented through the use of technology. Pre-recorded sounds from the same or any other area, narratives, music, soundscape compositions come to the surface during the walkthrough, usually with the use of GPS geolocated mobile applications. Although sound walks were established as an autonomous artistic practice rather recently, the term has been used since the 70s by members of the World Soundscape Project as a practice of browsing the soundscape of an area using a score map that draws the attention to unusual sounds. Mara Schaffer brings forth the issue of active listening and hence the plastic of the ears, and invents the term soundscape in order to describe our sound environment that becomes a central concept in the development of the interdisciplinary field that can be called sound studies. Moreover, the impact of the concept in anthropology becomes immediately evident in the pioneering ethnography of Stephen Feld, who marks the awareness of anthropologists in sound culture and addresses the soundscape as a cultural system, making him the theoretical proponent of epistemology, an epistemological model that exhibits the primacy of vision in Western art and science. From a different field of view, sound walks, audio walks, and listening walks are often related to the theoretical approaches of promenadology, Burckhardt, and Flavie, of course, Baudelaire, Benjamin, because as artworks they invite the walker or the listener into a wandering within an already augmented public space. Lucius Burckhardt, that I mentioned, derived from the field of architectural design and sociology, and uses the human body in motion in order to study urban space and proposes a broad approach of urban space, promenadology, whose principal methodological tool is walking, enriching the sensory intake of the built environment by the urban imaginary and pageantry of daydreaming. Walter Benjamin leads a significant theoretical role both by referring to Charles Baudelaire as the wanderer of the city of modernism and by taking over the role of the wanderer himself in his work on arcades that was unfortunately never completed. The concept of the passive walker in the city is transformed in the 20s by André Breton, who uses walking to experiment with automatic writing and to trigger certain social attitudes in public space. And of course the political stake is crystallized even more clearly in the 50s with the term psychogeography, a set of ideas and practices developed within the artistic current of letterists, criticizing urban geography. The letterist international and later the situationist international identifies a function of enforcement and monitoring within the city by exploring the emotional and psychological impact of urban planning and architecture to its inhabitants. Guy Debord's Psychogeographic Wandering Manual in the late 50s identifies and proposes a liberating dimension of the dream. That was kind of the story of the sound walk. So about audio walks that I am also into, I have to say that, since today I have to be in two places and I'm late even for even for this one. We are also supposed to conduct a workshop about a platform that we use. It's called NoTools. Since I will talk more, I can talk more about NoTools. To use this time as an introduction to the workshop that will happen later in the foyer. And less about other platforms, since it's the one that we use as a team, we are a team. So, of course, we are welcome to participate, any of you would like to come. We will prepare with your collaboration, if you're up for it, a geolocated working VR of the login. So, Located Media practices audiobooks using certain platforms as a tool, and we will be talking about NoTools, which is a free application with a fully and free accessible via internet editor created by the collective Escoitar.com based in Galicia, Spain. The user of NoTools can attach sounds on the map of an area, and later, when the listener is physically situated at the point of this attachment, he or she can hear the prelocated sounds through the system environment of a mobile phone. The freeware application detects the user listener's location via GPS and plays the geolocated audio files where they have been prelocated by the user. NoTools environment, as all Located Media technology, aims to reverse the process through which only certain cultural expression becomes part of the cultural heritage or dialogue, offering the community a tool to engage in the process by linking the real space with people's collective memory. The result is collaborative maps and audiobooks about and inside the city, the way its residents, walkers or visitors are experiencing it. Itineraries are thus created that evade from the concrete and primarily visually designed urban planning by suggesting a new cartographic model that could represent various layers of perception and experience of urban space. This model, based on movement, includes time, subjectivity, relational and emotional layers of experience, and finally it is open to a polyphonic narration about space and the process of its transformation into place through a walking ethnography, as Tim Ingold would suggest. Strolling within an already augmented city is an open-ended artistic gesture ready to be reinterpreted and retooled by each listener. These platforms are a tool for détournement, appropriating the widely spread format of touristic guides into a medium for non-touring and non-guiding, but still embedding the listener into long-touring. So, in relation to the principles of Horizon, and to nomadism, Deleuze and Guattari, first about Horizon, suggests that Horizon is a way to combine various conditions, the link between the image and the object world. It is the essence of any complex relationship between concepts, living organisms, body without organs, social conditions, political periods, and the essence of each unit of these relationships separately. Each system, not based on arborescence, on tree structure or root structure that made us suffer that much, and dichotomy is potentially rhizomatic. Through this point of view, many things can have the properties of a rhizome and be governed by its principles. Similarly, the practice of soundbooks, audiobooks, and listening books can be understood as a rhizomatic artistic entity, as a process both concerning the parts that are being composed and how this binding occurs, but also what might be the way to detect a rhizome into an artistic practice or interpret artistic works as rhizomes. This is a question. What relations are being developed between sounds within the environment in which they sound, and how a walking sound work functions within the space in which it sounds? And of course, what is the rhizomatic result? The relationship of sounds with walking, the relationship between the sounds and the city, or is it that art might be a rhizomatic process overall? A rhizome, just as any walking sound work, can connect any point to another point, and its traits are not necessarily linked to traits of the same nature, just as a rhizome is. Also, it is reducible neither to one nor the multiple. They are both not composed of units, but of dimensions and directions in motion. They have neither beginning nor end, but always a milieu from which they grow and which they overspill. They both constitute linear multiplicities having neither subject nor object, which can be laid out on a plane of consistency, and from which the one is always abstracted. Walking sound works are made only of lines as a rhizome is. lines of segmentarity and stratification as its dimensions, and the line of flight or deterritorialization as the maximum dimension after which the multiplicity undergoes metamorphosis, changes in nature. They are both not objects of reproduction, neither external reproduction onto a map as image tree, nor internal reproduction as tree structure. They are short-term memory or anti-memory, and operate by variation, expansion, conquest, capture, offshoots. It can pertain to a map that must be produced, constructed, a map that is always detachable, connectable, reversible, modifiable, and has multiple entryways and exits, and in its own lines of lights. It is the trackings that must be put onto a map, not the opposite, of course. In the same way, in all three types of walking, sound works, the roles of the artist and the listener often coincide, both in cases where sounds are recorded while crossing an area, and in those where the path chosen by the walker or the listener determines the artistic result. Walking sound works are a summary of the exploration of sound and research through sound and soundscape, linking the peripatetical proposal of Ingold or Burkhardt that we mentioned with their approaches to urban space, and could contribute to a political correlation of soundscape approaches of urban public studies, urban space studies, and of moving researches of human experience. The peripatetical dimension of such artistic project is critical and is fully compatible with relatively recent researches of Tim Ingold towards an ethnography of food. The link with the movement is both obvious as well as conceptual. About movement and nomad art, the Lausanne Guattari and Plateau assign it to a nomadic absolute, quote, as a local integration moving from part to part in an infinite succession of linkages and changes in direction. It is an absolute that it is one with becoming itself with process, end quote, from Mille Plateau. But a movement in terms of traveling or migrating here is not obligatory, of course. The goal is to crack through the system, I think he means this idipodial art that he says in Adin Dipus, that is described to be the conservative form of art, to achieve a breakthrough, another breakdown, and to manage to oppose to sovereignty and control in order to achieve change and creativity, and establish a process of continuous movement that is based on experience rather than explanation. The reason why they see nomad art as a consequence, as the outsider, as the itinerant ambulant that follows flows in vectorial fields across which singularities are scattered, and elsewhere, quote, as the streaming, spiraling, zigzagging, sneaking wheel to art, end quote. Deleuze and Guattari suggests a clear antithesis with the nomad way of being to the system of power that characterizes the state. This antithesis is verbally described as the different mode between nomadic and sedentary. When talking about the actual nomads, of course, they were defeated, let's say, by the state, because history is written by those who win. But the use of the concept of nomadism in this paper, as in Deleuze and Guattari's work, will not concentrate on nomadism as a way of social construction, but as a notion, as a concept that can be applied into various practices. This concept describes the revolutionary mode of conversing with the state, with the power and the control that exists in both in every human activity, including, of course, art. This is the reason why nomadism, in this view of explaining, is so deeply connected with the concept of the zone. It embraces a heterogeneity in free space and the need to occupy a rhizomatically linked smooth spaces, even if the hard space or the hard city that Jonathan Raban would describe as located in maps and statistics in monographs on urban sociology and demography and architecture stands in the way of its nomadic demand of free movement. However, the question to me that seems to be more appropriate about walking soundworks is which is actually the element that establishes the diplomatic and nomadic connection. The geolocated compositions that derive from movement of the city or the city itself. Geolocated compositions is highlighted in the audiobooks. The urban space element is highlighted in sound books, and listening books are about the conscious listening derive. As these artistic practices occur in public space, they point out additional relationships, not only the transmitter-receiver kind, but a more general context in which art functions socially. An additional nomadic element is emerging, the resident's possibility of direct involvement through narratives, stories, and sound imprint of their sonic identity. Furthermore, through such artistic practices, a citizen-centered approach is being suggested, which gives the worker, both the creator of the artwork and the listener, the possibility to use technology as a medium of interaction within public space and its inhabitants. The first and most apparent reason is the open source or freeware character of the softwares in use, and in Notus in particular, which offers the potential to use the editors and the downloadable application freely. In the case of Notus that we're mostly interested today, the users or the community of users' ability to develop parallel levels of digital spaces and or environments in the city is an aspect of the specialization of digital societies. Secondly, the inclusion of people's narratives and stories stresses out the importance of their involvement in the mapping process of an area. In this way, the built and the sound environment are intertwined with the emotional landscape that unfolds from the narrative of personal or collective memory. Moreover, the choice of the wandering route is made by the walker rather than the creator of the walk, which puts forth a cultural and social conjunction of spatial phonic routes and people. The walker is encouraged to wander freely in the city and re-establish a connection with the physical and oral environment of the small space, as well as to contribute to the artistic process by determining its form with its own body and his own movement. Well, to sum up, because I have to finish, as the lesson what I imply, many social activities, including art, can constitute a war machine, drawing a plane of consistency, a creative line of flight, a smooth place of displacement, by reforming or acting against the dominant systems and or practices. In the case of audio walking, nomadism does not apply by suggesting a flee from the city, but by proposing wandering as resistance to its confined and bordered space. In these soundscape compositions, narratives prevail, communities acquire space and voice, buildings are not a mere subjects for sightseeing tour. The city is not a collection of historical information, but a space to orally, artistically, socially wander through the microframes of which the space rhizomatically consists. Music and narratives as creative tools are used outside of the context of the content of ethnography, documentaries, scores, concert halls, museums, and institutions, and they become fragments of a living organism, of a city score whose music is made by and addressed to people. Actually, the notion of nomadism and war machine apply here as the war of becoming over being, what? Of the sedentary of the nomadic, end quote. So instead of a conclusion, allow me to quote again Deleuze and Guattari and share with you some thoughts that arise from all this. What interests us in striation and smoothing are precisely the passages and combinations. How the forces at work within space continually striated and how the course of its striation develops other forces and emits new smooth spaces. They stay towards the end of the novel. Well, I have mentioned here so far a nomadic way of creation that includes communities, collective and artistic experimentation with new media, public space, democratization of the medium and information, participative works of art, the inclusion of communities' narratives into public space interventions. Through new technology and artistic arts, there is a possibility to encourage connectivity, to encourage inclusion, integration, a community of spaces, people, and the routes between them. Will society use art's nomadic example, or will we stay striated, divided, and demarcated by walls, enclosures and most of all fences. We live in very difficult times, politically, socially, and financially. And when one is engaged into walking artistic practices, as I am and as I am talking to you today, there's no way to ignore that walking represents for some people a way to survive and a hope for a better life and basic human rights. We were using Flandry as a starting political point in a country. But we live, and all of us live, in countries where there are people that actually walk from very, very far to get here, and most of them die in our borders. And we should not ignore that all human rights, of course, should apply to these people as well. And there is now more than ever a central demand to move over, to allow others to move over, to learn how to live together, as simple as it sounds, we still haven't mastered it, and to deterritorialize our history and just focus on our geography, on a nomadic assemblage that will resist by becoming inclusive, by creating new routes and smooth places to claim, to occupy, and to be able to walk and allow the walk through. Thank you very much.